Let's get the obvious stuff out of the way. In the animal kingdom, life consumes one another, plants, fungi, and animals alike. All life on Earth is genetically related via DNA. This fact alone makes it clear that humans are animals, as the tree of life in biology showcases this. By the virtue of these two facts, nature operates on the basis of an equilibrium, a balanced food chain, the mutual agreement of the Earth's evolutionary history. However, the concept of evolution clearly states that life is an ever-changing process. It is how organisms adapt and shift form over the course of millions and millions of years. So, evolution itself is constantly evolving. Is this a redundant statement? Sure. But it is sad that I must remind scientists of this fact. By virtue of the evolutionary model, things are never the same on a universal timescale, including the fundamental forces of reality, implying that all things, including cultural paradigms, evolve, change, adapt. A civilization that does not adapt to the natural changes of the Earth will collapse, as they have time and time again. It wasn't just empirical expansions overstepping their boundaries. It was the failure to recognize that all life abides to a natural law. A civilization that respects and acknowledges this natural law will prosper. Despite what many critics of veganism think, what was just said above is the fundamental basis of the veganism movement, and I will explain how and why. Part 1. Taking things at face value. From the outside perspective, veganism appears to be a social trend in dietary changes, consisted of people who impose their views onto others. This trend, along with others, attributes to a movement that people label as the Social Justice Warrior Movement, hence SJWs. To begin with, I find it strange when people are opposed to social justice. What's the real issue here? As a person who uses the internet to share ideas, I look at people's interactions from a psychological perspective, and what I've noticed about people is that they are so used to their perspective that they make the mistake to think that their perspective is the normal one, while all other perspectives are secondary in value. I've noticed that when being presented with a foreign concept, instead of taking the time to understand the other perspective, people tend to immediately throw insults and shut down the alien perspective, taking things at face value at every point in their lives, so that their reality is shaped based off of their basic knowledge. Hence, their intelligence level and range of awareness is extremely limited, which results in the inability to understand self-sacrifice when they see it. I want to make it particularly clear for those who haven't shut this video off already. Vegans are fully aware that humans are omnivores and that animals eat each other in the natural world. The origins of veganism are not entrenched in the ideology that humans are not meant to eat meat, despite the popular opinion. Veganism stems from the acknowledgement of the current state of the world. And if anyone actually takes the time to simply look at the facts, they would most definitely understand the perspective of the vegans. So let's take a look at the facts. Number 2. An atrocity to the natural law. This chart is known as the Tree of Life in biology, a catalog of all the living things on this planet. This chart reveals that all life on Earth, from bacteria to animals and plants, are all genetically related through DNA. Many people whom I've debated with refuse to acknowledge this fact. It forces them to reevaluate their belief systems that gave them the delusion that humans are not animals. It's almost like the movie 1984, when the people were mentally programmed to believe that 2 plus 2 equals 5. No matter what the facts are, they refuse to acknowledge the truth of the nature of reality. And the truth is, humans, in every sense of the word, are animals. I go into detail about this in my Redefining People video, but for this video, I just want to make it clear that humans have all the same desires, wants, and needs as all other forms of life. In fact, our presence on this planet is a new thing relative to all other forms of life. We are the new kids on the block, ignorant of our place in the world, arrogantly boasting that we are above all things. And due to this foolish ideology, members of the human race commit the most atrocious crimes that can never be justified. I highly recommend you all watch a documentary called Earthlings. For those who are not spiritually dead, this will be the most heartbreaking documentary that you will ever see. But it's necessary to be seen. The truth must be revealed so that people can get mad. By getting mad at the situation, we will muster the will to change the situation. Earthlings showcases the role animals play in our daily lives, from food entertainment. It showcases a perspective that snaps the viewer back into reality and view the situation from an ethical perspective. The problem therein lies in the fact that we treat animals as resources rather than acknowledge them as family, hence the tree of life, the earth family tree.
And when you say resources, you're talking about our relatives, you're talking about our family. Fish are our family, it's not a resource, it's family. It requires all the respect.
The same kind of respect that the Aboriginals of the world hold. The same people that our society labels as backwards. Who's really backwards here? People don't see what is obvious because there's a veil that obscures their vision. This veil is the metaphor for describing the mental filtration system that shapes reality based off of the reference frame of the being. It is this very reason why cognitive dissonance occurs within the minds of those who ridicule veganism. The obvious is as follows. Our materialistic reductionist society operates on the belief that all life is an accident, and that consciousness is an accident of the brain, and that animals and plants are without consciousness, rendering their existence to reactionary based impulses like machines. This results in a society that does not give a shit about life and seeks to maximize profits regardless of social or environmental loss. The reality of this situation is that all animals are in fact people, part of the same earth family tree that we are a part of, and we subject our family members to a lifetime of torture because it is cost effective to our precious economy. The same economy that profits off of the destruction of the planet and off of the wars instigated by people who seek to maximize profit.
Cortou.
O quê?
Pra gente poder comer, porque senão a gente ia ter que engolir inteiro.
Mas, por quê?
Pra comer, amor. Igual corta o boi, corta a galinha.
Ah, a galinha? Ninguém come também.
Ninguém come a galinha?
É, é os animais.
É?
É.
Tá bom.
Todos esses são os animais. Esse é os animais. O povo é os animais. Cães é os animais. Vaca é os animais. Porco é os animais. Então, quando a gente comer os animais, eles morrem. Por quê?
Pra gente poder comer, meu amor.
Porque eles morrem. Não gosto porque eles morrem. Eu gosto que eles ficam em pé.
Então tá bom. Então a gente não vai comer mais não, tá bom?
Tá. Esses animais são tem que cuidar deles, não comer.
Tá certo, meu filho.
Por que você tá sonhando?
Não tô chorando, não. Eu tô emocionada com você.
Number 3. Cultural reflection and reevaluation. Veganism is a part of a greater paradigm shift. Its call for action not only requires a change to one aspect of our lives, but a change to our existence on Earth in totality. For this goes beyond animal rights and dietary changes. This is about ethical and moral values, what we deem to be worthless and priceless. And ultimately, it's about what kind of species we want to be. We have the knowledge, the technology, and the feasibility to build an entirely new civilization. And yet, despite this, people of the world have simply accepted the world they were born into and deem it to be the way that things are supposed to be. This results in the prevalence of the broken systems of the world today. Systems that have proven themselves to be corrupted. Humans passively allow the atrocities of the world to continue. We keep ourselves locked within a mental prison. The Matrix, if you will. And we could easily fix all of this. The first step is to stop shutting down people who are voicing what must be heard. The fact that the term social justice warrior exists means that an effort has been made to subdue the awakening taking place, just as it was subdued during the 1960s. Ironic. The people who coined SJWs and see them as brainwashed puppets of special interest groups are exactly what they project onto others. A subconscious self-reflection in all its ironic glory. As I said before, veganism is part of a greater movement, the awakening of the human race. Number 4. Neohumanism. For those who watch my videos, you know that I am very adamant about neohumanism. It is the only clear description of the new consciousness emerging amongst humans. This new consciousness recognizes that we are all the universe experiencing itself subjectively. Neohumanism applies this understanding to the way they view and treat animals, plants, and life as a whole. Ideally, neohumanism is the concept that all things in the universe are treated with respect and love. A society that operates on this basis would shed away all aspects of violence, divisions, and segregation. These old ways of being are no longer part of the human experience. This results in a cosmic civilization that exists in equilibrium with the planet. A Type 1 civilization, this is the next step of our evolutionary chain. Veganism is an aspect of neohumanism in that it invokes a change of the cultural paradigm. Whether we realize it or not, culture is the basis of society. All technologically advanced societies seem to one way or the other follow the Western model of civilization design and culture, which is materialism. Society and civilization is this complex, intricate matrix that consists of mental faculties, social programming, psychological programming, and cultural programming. Each of these contribute to the fabric of the web that holds civilization together. And the architecture and city design of civilization is a reflection of the culture of the society, a reflection of where our head is at as a species. As documentaries such as Earthlings show, our societies have produced hell on Earth for animals and humans. Anyone could read about the recent history and see the ramifications of mental programming. How humans treat each other is a testimony to the sickness of our species, and we must make amendments to our societies, starting with the law. Much like how we had to make amendments to destroy racism and preserve human rights.
What we're talking about here, surely tonight, at the core of what we're discussing, is values. That's what it's about, human values. Martin Luther King talked about power without compassion, might without morality, and strength without sight. They are the values that allow our societies to abuse animals. But they are the values also that allow our societies to abuse people and to abuse the planet as well in the name of economics. You cannot divorce the values that abuse animals and those that abuse people and abuse the planet, for they are the same values. It was Henry Salt, a great social reformer and animal rights campaigner, because again, the two are indivisible, who said early on in this century, it is useless to preach peace by itself, social justice by itself, or kindness to animals by itself. The cause, he said, of each of all the evils that afflict the world is the same, the general lack of humanity, the lack of knowledge that all sentient life is akin, and that he who injures a fellow being is in fact doing injury to himself. It is not this bloodshed or that bloodshed that must cease, he said, but all needless bloodshed, all wanton infliction of pain or death upon our fellow beings. And if the people who run this country and run other countries do not see that, then maybe they do need a bill of rights for animals to constantly remind them. For that will do if we start treating animals with dignity.
We must make an amendment to all laws, recognizing that all life is interconnected and that it is of utmost importance that we develop a respect towards the planet. The preservation of all life on the Earth and the Earth itself will be one of the defining aspects of this new paradigm. Number 5. Amendment. Recognize that we are responsible for the destruction of the biosphere and the 6th mass extinction that is currently underway. Recognize that we must adapt, compromise, and sacrifice in order for our future generations to live a life that is truly free on a world that is a reflection of the Garden of Eden. We must put an end to our overconsumption of natural resources, and we must put an end to the atrocities committed to animals. It is highly unnecessary to eat what can be replaced with what the earth already provides. Supplements can substitute the properties of meat that are essential to us. For those who are so accustomed to eating meat, I understand completely. Personally, I would much rather prefer to eat meat from an animal that lived its life long and happily, the way things were supposed to be, rather than living its whole life in a factory, waiting for slaughter. The conditions that of which we subject the animals of today are worse than the conditions found in concentration camps and the death camps of the Nazis. So, if people really do want to eat meat, they can hunt it for themselves, using only hunting tools. No traps, no poison, just straight up skill of tracking and hunting. This would be fair for both entities, the animal and the human, for the animal can simply escape if the human is not skilled enough. Which again forces them to adapt. What's the issue? Considering we have the technology to make whatever kind of food we want, why not make meat supplements in the form of food instead of just junk food, which is already an artificial food that we just love to fill our kids with? What it comes down to is the fact that humans of today, when faced with the task to take responsibility, would rather laze around and have decisions made for them. That is the root of their resistance towards any concept that involves the reprogramming or reconstruction of our obviously flawed and broken system. So how do we communicate to those who remain ignorant? Communicate to them using their language. Here's what I mean. Number 6, the language of change. As you may have found out by now, my videos explore the psychological and sociological aspects of humanity. Through Jacques Fresco's teachings, I have developed an understanding of how the human mind is shaped based off upon the experiences of the being. I've also learned that no human is truly evil. Everyone literally thinks that what they're doing is the right thing, for them or for their family. Despite how people's actions may appear from the outside perspective, one cannot make sense of someone else's ideologies. Especially not during a one-dimensional interaction of name-calling and boasting. In order to communicate to other people about these concepts that are foreign to them, one must understand the other person's perspective. This will allow you to communicate to that person in a manner that does not degrade them. This will negate any hostilities facilitated by emotional outbursts, which in turn opens a window of opportunity for you to exploit during the debate. As someone who is undergoing the awakening process, I have debated with all kinds of people who represent many different perspectives. They all believe that they are in the norm. These are all ideological traps. But how do we make a decision as a species if everyone thinks that they are right? The answer is quite simple. Before choosing an action, ask yourself, does my action negatively affect a life form of any kind? If so, this action is not the correct choice to make. Humans who understand this principle will develop a culture of neo-humanistic characteristics. Every debate you engage in is an opportunity to change someone's life. Even if it is one breakthrough, It is enough to echo into the course of the future. Enough echoes will in turn change the course of humanity, changing our way from the destroyers of the planet to the vanguards of the planet. That is what veganism is all about.